to sell, the county Paris makes wedding arrangements to the old friars to surprise and alarm.
On Thursday, sir. The time is very short.
My father Capulet will have it so.
And you say you do not know the lady's mind? I like it not. Look, sir, here comes the lady toward myself.
Happily met, my lady and my wife.
Are you at leisure, holy father? Now?
My lord, we must entreat the time alone.
Come weep with me, past hope, past cure, past hell.
Oh, Juliet, I already know thy grief. I hear thou must, on Thursday next, be married to this county.
If in thy wisdom, thou canst give no help, with this knife, I'll help it presently.
The friar has another plan. Juliet must take one of his medicines, a sleeping potion.
Hold, daughter, I do spy a kind of hope. Go home, be merry, consent to marry Paris. Wednesday is tomorrow. Tomorrow night, look that thou lie alone. Let not thy nurse lie with thee in thy chamber. Take thou this vial, being then in bed, and this distilled liquor drink thou off. When presently, through all thy veins, shall run a cold humor, the roses in thy lips and cheeks shall fade. Each part shall appear like death. And in this death thou shalt continue 2 and 40 hours, and wake as from a pleasant sleep.
The friar will write for Romeo to come, and when Juliet wakes, he will take her to Mantua alone.
In the meantime shall Romeo, by my letters, know our drift, and hither shall he come. And he and I will watch thy waking. And that very night shall Romeo bear thee hence to Mantua.
Love, give me strength. Farewell, dear father.
Juliet returns home to follow the friar's instructions. She agrees to marry Paris.
So many guests invite her here as writ. What, is my daughter gone to Friar Lawrence?
See, here she comes from shrift with merry look.
I have learned me to repent the sin of disobedient opposition to you. Pardon, I beseech you.
Send for the county. I'll have this knot knit up tomorrow morning.
No, not till Thursday. There is time enough.
Look to church tomorrow. My heart is wondrous light.
That night, Juliet prepares to take the sleeping potion.
Shall meet again. My dismal CI needs us not alone. What if this mixture do not work at all? What if it be a poison? How if, when I am laid in my tomb, awake before the time that Romeo come, shall I not then be stifled in the vault, to whose foul mouth no howsoever breathes in, and there die, strangled, or, if I live, is it not like that I, sorely waking, run mad? Oh, look! Methinks I see my cousin's ghost seeking out Romeo! Stay, Tybalt, stay. Romeo, I come. This do I drink to thee.
Night passes quickly, and the nurse comes to dress Juliet for church.
Mistress! What, Juliet? What lamb? What lady? Fie, you like a bed. How sound is she asleep? I must needs awake her. Lady, lady, help, help! My lady's dead! Ah!
What is the matter?
Look, look!
Oh me, my child, my only life.
Let me see her. She's cold. Her blood is settled and her joints are on her like an untimely frost on the sweetest flower in all the field.
Oh, lamentable day!
Oh, woeful time!
Death ties up my tongue and will not let me speak.
Come, is the bride ready to go to church?
Ready to go, but never to return. Death is my son-in-law, my daughter he hath wedded. Life, living, all is death's.
Peace, hope, for shame. Heaven and yourself had part in this fair maid. Now heaven hath all, and all the better it is for the maid. Dry up your tears and bear her to church.
All things that we ordain festival turn from their office to black funeral, our instruments to melancholy bells, our bridal cheer as a sad burial feast, our wedding flowers as a burial corpse, and all things change them to the contrary.
Sir, go you in, and Madame,
and go, Sir Paris.
Everyone prepared to follow this fair corpse into her grave.
Friar writes Romeo of Juliet's pretend death, but the messenger is delayed and the letter never arrives.
So in Mantua, the banished Romeo knows nothing of the friar's plan. Romeo has had a dream about good news and he feels lighthearted.
My dreams presage some joyful news at hand. My bosom's lord sits lightly on his throne. I dreamt my lady found me dead and breathed such life with kisses in my lips that I revived and was an emperor. News from Verona. What ho, Balthazar? Is my lady well? Is my father well? How doth my lady? This I say again, for nothing can be ill if she is well.
Then if she is well, nothing can be ill. Her body sleeps in Capel's monument. And her immortal part with the angel's lips. Oh, pardon me for bringing these ill news.
Is it even so? Then I defy you, stars. Send those horses. We will hence tonight. Then, dear Juliet, seems that I shall lie with thee tonight.
Since he thinks Juliet is dead, Romeo decides to die with her. He visits a poor old apothecary who sells drugs and potions.
I do remember an apothecary, and hereabouts he dwells. And in his needy shop, a tortoise hung, an alligator stuffed, and other skins of ill-shaped fishes. And said I to myself, if ever a man did need poison now, here lives a wretch who would sell it him. What ho, apothecary!
Who calls so loud?
I see that thou art poor. Here's 40 ducats. Give me a dram of poison.
Such mortal drugs I have, but Mantua has lost death.
Famine is in my cheeks.
My poverty, but not my will consent.
I pay that poverty, not thy will.
Put this in any liquid thing and drink it off.
Here's thy gold. Farewell.
That night, Juliet is placed into her tomb. Paris comes to put flowers on the grave of his bride.
Hex and stand aloof. Whistle, the signal that thou hearest something approach. Give those flowers. Do as I bid thee. Go.
Gentle youth, tempt not a desperate man.
I do apprehend thee for a felon here.
Oh Lord, they fight! I will call the blood.
Oh, I am slain. If thou be merciful, open the tomb and lay me with Juliet.
You have my word. Noble County Paris, said, my man? I think he said that this Paris should have married Juliet. Give me thy hand. One wrote with me and saw in misfortune's book.
In the tomb, Romeo says farewell to his bride.
Oh, my love, my wife. Death hath had no power yet upon thy beauty. Why art thou yet so fair? Here, I will set up my everlasting rest. Eyes, look your last. Arms, take your last embrace. And lips, seal with the righteous kiss. A dateless bargain to engrossing death. Here's to my love. Oh, true apothecary, thy drugs are quick. Thus, with a kiss, I die.
Fear comes upon me. Alack, alack! What blood is this? Romeo, oh pale! Who else? What, Paris too? The lady stirs.
Oh, comfortable friar, where is my lord? I do remember well where I should be, and there I am. Where is my love?
I hear some noise. Lady, come away from that nest of death. Come, come away. Thy husband there lies dead, and Paris too. Come, go, good Juliet. I dare no longer stay.
Juliet realizes Romeo has only died a few minutes before, and she wants to join him in death.
What's here? A cup closed in my true lover's hand. Poison I see hath been his timeless end. O churl, drunk all and left no friendly drop to help me after. I will kiss thy lips. Happily some poison yet doth hang on them. Thy lips are warm!
Lead, boy, which way?
Yea, noise. Then I'll be brief. Oh, happy dagger, this is thy sheath. There rust, and let me die.
Oh, heavens! Oh, wife, look how our daughter bleeds!
Oh, me!
Bring forth the party to suspicion!
I am the greatest.
Then say at once what thou doth know in this.
I will be brief. Romeo, they're dead, was husband to that Juliet. I married them. Then gave I her a sleeping potion. But when I came, here lay the noble Paris and true Romeo dead. She, too desperate, would not go with me.
Where be these enemies? Capulet? Montague? Heaven finds means to kill your joys with love.
Over the bodies of their dead children, Capulet and Montague declare peace.
Oh, brother Montague, give me thy hand. No more can I demand.
Only one thing can the fathers do, put up gold statues of their dead children.
But I could give thee more, for I'll raise her statue in pure gold, that while, Verona, by that name is known, there shall no figure at such rate be set as that of true and faithful Juliet.
As rich shall Romeo by his lady lie, for sacrifices of our enmity.
A blooming peace this morning with the brings. The sun for sorrow will not show its head. Go hence and have more talk of these sad things. Some will be pardoned and some punished, but for never was a story of more woe than this of Juliet and her Romeo.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, oh, oh.